I represent a company called Digi Telecom. As I just about setting up the slide, I thought let me utilize the time so that we can do that. Coming in immediately after Airtel is almost like a David and Goliath kind of story. Obviously, we are proud of it and very excited about it. Digi Telecom is a company which is headquartered out of Nagpur, in central India. It's a startup which is took its birth in 2009 with a very young team with an average age of 21 years. I think I'm supposed to stay at the podium, right? Organizers? Yeah, okay. They said don't dance around because the audio is not being captured. All right. Bigvi Telecom, as the name suggests, is all about voice. All incoming voice to any ecosystem is intelligently managed and send forward selectively to the desired end users. That's the broad bottom line that we represent as an organization. So the product that we want to talk with you in this category is known as YOCC, Your Own Call Center. YOCC, Your Own Call Center, which works on the cloud technology. I'll first take you through the basic application and how it works, where exactly it is used, and then we can also take it out on the technology front. Out of the 20 minutes allotted to us, since we are a startup, young organization, we would like to invest our 10 minutes in discussing our product, and probably would like to give a broader time to answer your questions and also to learn from you as to how better we could use this application, if that is acceptable to the jury. Thank you so much. Now here we are putting our candidature forth for innovative managed service in telecom. That's the category in which we are putting forward our candidature for Your Own Call Center. Prima facie, we look at what exactly does the market wish to manage. Now, when I use the word manage, I'm talking about management of all incoming voice packets and what are the basic wishes of the organizations. We are looking at small and medium enterprises as our target group, right? So typically middle market transactions. Now, these are the three broad areas that we thought was very challenging for SME sector. Talking about CRM, we are talking about risk management, we are talking about resource management. All the three terminologies are self-explanatory, but broadly in the first category, we are looking at converting all the incoming voice packets into information, intelligent information, which could give value for the customer and the consumers, and which could drive business for them further. Now, these are the three broad areas. When you talk about call center, the first logical or the first broad answer that comes is there's a hardware call center solution available in the market. There are established call centers available in the market, which probably has a lot of scalability and could give a lot of information. Now we look at a huge capex when you're trying to go in for a hardware call center, or when you try to go in for a run-of-the-mill call center, which is very easily available off the shelf. And also a huge operating expenditure in terms of the kind of manpower required, in terms of kind of maintenance required on a day-to-day basis. You also have a lot of resource drain into non-core functions because let's say I'm a real estate expert, I'm a real estate company, and my core competency should be revolving around real estate, but here I go in for a call center and I find that many of my energy is revolving around that. Again, leveraging weakness when scaling up operations. So typically an organization, let's say in the food industry or in the education industry, the moment they scale from one location to multiple location, any kind of hardware call center solution fizzles out because then you have to go for their own specific WAN which connects them and leverages them across. Quickly moving on to, there's a broad gap analysis that we could do along the five basic areas. You look at intelligent automation, convergence of voice data. So that's the gap that we could find in the market, which actually propelled us to move into this segment at Bigvi Telecom. Moving further, this is how we defined the market need. We felt that the market needs an intelligent, cost-effective solution. Cost-effective is important for us, which optimizes the resources at hand to deliver seamless convergence, wherein we say that, okay, a voice packet lands onto the customer side, it's logged on electronically, this electronic logging converts into data, this data converts into intelligent reporting, which is all in situ, pari passu happening on the system. So that's the market need that we could look at. And then it says that, okay, with telecom as its backbone and bandwidth not being a constraint. So before we moved on to YOC or your own call center as a product for us, we said that this is what the market need is. And this is the kind of topography we built. We could come later to this if you have any technical questions on this. Now this is a very broad, very crude schematic diagram which shows what we are trying to do. So you can see voice and data packets landing. You have a IVRS equivalent kind of system which intercepts the voice and data packets and converts it to the relevant areas. Beyond that, IVRS is a kind of front face for our product. And once it gets through IVRS, gets directed selectively to the right place, then these are the five broad areas or the five services that we manage for our clients. Broadly, intelligent automation, selectively directed, stored and reported, predefined feedback, and effective CRM. At this juncture, I'll quickly take few live examples, which will also tell you about the social impact, which will also tell you about the kind of applications that we are into right now. Let's take the education segment. We have a product which is used specifically for the schools, which serves as a kind of diode between all incoming information for the school management, which comes in terms of voice, which could be from the parents, which could be from the transporter, which could be from the bus owner, a driver, conductor, or the remedial classes master, right, as an incoming, and then selectively outgoing student-wise. Okay, that's one application area that we deal into. Looking at reality sector, broadly speaking, any application where there is a huge load of voice content falling at a particular point, which could be a EPBX, which could be a range of numbers, which could be a BRI line, and then which needs to be again transferred to multiple users intelligently. That's where YOC comes into the picture. Now, YOC has got this software utility which we call Cranium. Cranium is the brain which actually gives it all the intelligence that YOC has and which in turn helps you in managing the services upfront. So typically you look at it, you have a lot of voice content packets coming into it. They are either attended through IVRS or there are some call alerts. Like let's say the call has not been received, so you have some alerts going on to the respective people. Or there's a deadlock message which is sent back to the user. One of the three happens before my voice packet actually enters Cranium, which is the knowledge management center utility built inside YOC. Now what Cranium does is, if you see the upper half, these are all inbound applications in the sense that all calls which are coming in, and if you look at the box lower towards the lower half of the page, these are all outbound call applications which happens to the call. So let me take one of them. A voice comes and wants to, let's take an example. Let's say I'm talking of rural healthcare, right? A voice comes in of the district hospital in charge who wants to know, as far as maternal cases are concerned in rural areas, where the ninth month is due and a particular medicine is to be taken by the pregnant woman 1 month before actually reporting to the hospital. Now this selective call treatment, so the if you look at the user side, it's a historical database. So right from the day the pregnancy has been logged in, the system can calculate when is it going to be 1 week before the 9 months, right? On that day, the logged information, the district hospital in charge need not be alert on that time. He feeds in the historical information and then that goes as an alert to the right user at the right time. Similarly, electronic log of database, someone wants to review what all has happened on a particular log and how it has been attended, what is the duration of the call, what is the average duration of the call, how many calls have been dropped. In a case where a call has been dropped, the user also gets an alert that this call was not attended to, so that offline you could take that call, right? So these are some of the inbound applications that Cranium does in terms of managing the services. And if you look at this converts text to voice, you know, typically where one voice content wants to reach out to multiple users, let's say a Baba Ramdev or a Shiv Khera or any luminary whose voice content is to be heard by millions, zillions of people. That's why we say convert text to voice, where you record your voice, leave it on a log, and then broadcast it to multiple users through this utility called Trainium. If you have specific questions to that, then we could elaborate it further. So that's how broadly the management of telecom services is happening through York from our end. This is a broad topography on which York works. I'm just rushing through these slides. Few advantages of York that we proffer to our customers. Solutions can be tailor-made. As I told you initially, that it's a software solution, so it can be tailor-made to the specific needs of the user. Absolutely no capex, there's no capital expenditure involved, and very minimal amount of opex, because the Cranium is working at the back end, at the server end, which is managed by us. Focus minimal on non-core functions. So at the client side, once they have installed a York, as far as managing incoming voice content is concerned, they need not have any focus. They just explain it to our knowledge management center at once. We program it in the Cranium, and then that takes care of it. We promise no dissipation of voice data, because all incoming voice is logged electronically, and we maintain a log sheet as to what has happened to what any particular voice data that comes into it. A lot of value-added services are available on this in terms, the basic product being York, but it could be further programmed into various avatars which specifically suits your requirement. And of course, it's an enabler for a competent CRM. We don't say that it's a complete CRM package in itself, but it's an enabler because it selectively feeds data into a good CRM system that the company could have. As we talk about advantages, these are some of the apparent disadvantages that one may have in his mind as to what is the security of data and voice routed through vendor server, right? Everything is encrypted. We follow the highest quality standards as far as encryption is concerned. And for high-ticket users, we also dedicate servers on site so that the physical location of the server is also on their site, and we just manage it remotely for them. Some people also talk about the quality of network security on the cloud computing that we're using. And some people also have questions on Big V Telecom being a startup. So, okay, as a startup, we are nimble and that much more faster. Customization is possible. So broadly, that's what York is all about. Very, very much focused right now on the small and medium enterprises, and we are slowly entering into the middle market right now. This is what we have achieved in the last 3 years that we have been into the market. Almost a 389% CAGR is what we have been able to post in the last 3 years that we have been into the market. 25,000 plus customers spread across various industry verticals. Started off very majorly into real estate and then moved into education. Even today, almost 48% of our customers are on these two verticals, slowly moving on to other verticals as we are learning the tricks of each of those verticals. BSNL has patronized us in a big way in these four circles for a lot of VaaS services that we provide for them. This is a broad breakup of industry verticals that we have handled in these 3 years. As you can see, 13% is the government sector that we're talking about, which is very significant for us right now with our size. And we are doing a lot of applications with this York in rural healthcare with a few governments. If you look at education, of course, there are a lot of applications. In the government sector, again, per se, there's a lot of outbound voice application that is happening. As you put forward your question, we can take a specific example from that. These are some of the benchmarks that we have been able to achieve internally. Again, very proud of having achieved this. The servers that we are maintaining at our own end, the downtime of those servers, the satisfaction index that we have, the quality assurance standards that we have. Promise quotient is again a very big HR parameter internally in our organization, where we say that promise quotient is equivalent to promises made divided by promises delivered. And we don't want it to fall below one. And from the customer satisfaction point of view, That's a very strong parameter in which the entire team at Wigwi works. This is what we are looking at right now as, to share our plans. We are looking at a payment gateway on mobile. When I say payment gateway, we are not trying to compete with products like Airtel Money, because that's from the payment point of view. What we say here is that as we are converting voice into intelligent information, there are certain intelligent information which also needs to be paid upfront if they need really need to be scaled up or they really need to go across. That's where we are trying to develop a utility, which again will piggyback back to back on some utility like Airtel Money or anything else that comes into the market at that time. So we are not trying to be a finance company, or we are not trying to be a payment house, but we are trying to facilitate it as a software center to our customers, especially in the rural healthcare market. Way2Voice is the cranium center that we spoke about, which does all the management of innovation services. Now we are trying to develop a mobile app for it, so that the client at the client end right now, they can view all this happening on the web portal. We are trying to develop an application so that they could view all this online on a mobile screen, on a smartphone, through a mobile app on the move. I think I have taken more than 10 minutes on that now. These are some of our clients who are excited about us: Ramoji Film City, Dentistry, it's a chain of dentists across the country, Mege Group, it's a big educational group based out of Central India, Nimal, they're big into real estate in Mumbai, Tours and Travels, Drishti again into education. These are the five questions which people have asked us wherever we go. I don't know whether these are the five questions that you'd also like to ask us, but just in case, I could answer them if they are of your choice. Otherwise, I throw the house open for questions from the jury. As we told you, being a startup, we not only want to download what we are, we also want to upload and learn from you. Thank you very much. Yeah. Okay, let me come back to the question. What is your strategy to stay ahead of competition? Okay, are you aware of any competition for a product like this? Okay. Right. See, to the best of our knowledge, the domain that we are into, we do not have any competition as of now, to the best of our knowledge, which could be improved further upon from your side. But yes, at the generic level, talking about cloud telephony at a very generic sense, there are a lot of applications available. What we say is, what differentiates our product from anything else in the market today is the power of cranium that we have inbuilt into that Way2Voice portal that we have, which has gone through the learning curve, or rather is going through the learning curve of specific industry verticals, right? Where we understand the specific needs of that particular industry vertical, program it into cranium so that for that particular industry vertical, it becomes almost a customized product as it was conjured, conceptualized and delivered for them. Right. As we showed you that in the past, we have been able to develop that learning curve across 9 industry verticals where we are very comfortable as far as their needs are concerned. As we are growing, we have a knowledge management center working independently on various industry verticals. So as we empower Cranium more and more on specific industry needs suited to a vertical, we feel that it will keep on running ahead of competition that much more. So it's one thing to say that I use petrol for running my car, but it's another to say that my car is very much customized to run on Indian roads. So of course it runs on petrol, so to that extent we are same, but then I run on Indian roads without any problem, and probably you are a Mercedes-Benz which doesn't run on Indian roads. So that's where the divergence starts as far as the product is concerned. So. Uh, Just to correct, I was talking about voice to data. Our company's raw material is voice content. Yeah. Right. Okay. You're talking about the repository, right? Yeah. Okay. We are right now supporting it in 11 vernaculars. Okay. Effort is on to move on to more vernaculars. That's why if you see the geographic distribution of our, if you do a cluster analysis of our customers, we are more clustered around south, west, and central India right now. Typically, we are not very strong in north, we are not very strong in the east right now. And that sort of says the kind of vernacular that we are moving ahead with, because we really want to provide that vernacular support, otherwise it makes absolutely no sense as you go more rural. 24897 to be precise, yeah. At this juncture, we are very comfortable with the domain of SME. We would like to move ahead beyond SME, because when we launched this product 3 years back, we said that, okay, even if you have to learn and learn through our mistakes, let's do it on a segment which cannot damage us permanently. Now that we feel that certain segments, certain industry verticals, we have done our learning curve, we want to move ahead on those segments. So typically, if we have been handling a normal lifestyle in real estate, we are now ready to move to a DLF or to a Unitech kind of organization.
I wanted to inquire about health services. Which all state the governments are providing to, and what are the kind of services
provided? Right. Till now, we have worked with four governments. Primarily Chhattisgarh government, Madhya Pradesh government, Maharashtra government, and on a pilot basis right now on a Tamil Nadu government, right? Now, different applications. In Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh, it's about rural healthcare, as in maternal care. In fact, that's one of our products which has been slotted in one of the categories, I think value-added services category. Yeah, value-added service category, which is called Matrutva. Now what this product does is, I will explain it in detail when we come under that category, but broadly what it does is, typically in the tribal areas of Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh, the maternal deaths are as high as 67%, and the neonatal deaths are as high as 42%, right? So what it does is, what the government has done is, they have hired a team of ASHA workers who are sort of educated housewives representing a particular village. They are supposed to log on the pregnancy. So the moment a woman gets pregnant, the earliest that it can be logged on to a central server, so they provide that function. And the concerned district hospital tracks those dates from there on, advising the women about the PNC checks and the DNC checks, so prenatal and neonatal, both. And ASHA worker drives it. So ASHA worker has a mobile handset. Many of these women also have today, but we terminate at the ASHA worker level, where periodic alerts are sent to them, and those alerts are further forwarded to those women who already have a handset. So it's a two-way communication. Some of these women have some problems midway where they want to come into a doctor to check. What was happening earlier was, they used to come all the way to the district hospital and they find that the doctor is not there, or the queue is too long, and they go all the way back and come again back and forth. Now here what happens? She comes with a prior appointment where the doctor is waiting for them with the right kind of... There is a lot of slip between the cup and the lip. There is. But we do provide a backbone which helps take baby steps towards the right direction. We are working on it, we are learning every day, and we are moving ahead on that. Alright, we didn't deserve any questions from sir, so I thought let me... So we are a team of 39 youngsters. I am the oldest, whatever you look at me. With an average age of 20 years, 7 months to be precise. We all very strongly believe that mobile is the platform. It will further get, the screen size will get smaller down the line, and all convergence has to happen on this platform. and the entire team is working on that. So it's very much Indian, very much Central India, very much Nagpur. We are very proud to say that we are from an emerging market like Nagpur, which otherwise is a test center for many product launches, Nagpur, Lucknow, Ahmedabad typically. But it has become a very strong powerhouse because in the past period, as many as 56 engineering colleges are there in Nagpur. Very smart young force, so the product is typically Indian, typically Central India, typically Nagpur. Everything is indigenous. See, cloud telephony is, there's nothing new in that idea, it's there. Handling voice packets on a cloud is again very much known to the market, nothing new about it. But the idea of developing Cranium or developing a knowledge management center which provides industry-specific intelligence was a value addition that our team thought, and we thought that, okay, this is the road to go forward. And so to that extent, we can say that this idea is ours. But I can't say that cloud is mine or cloud technology is mine or VAS on cloud is mine. No, that's I believe, a very much a product of the global village. Sure. Innovation is more on the eco-service and ecosystem and more on the specific industry verticals that we're dealing with, because typically in our country, more so requirements really change, right? The core requirement is same. So CRM at a generic level would be same for everyone. Everyone wants to have a customer relationship management. But what is CRM for a school principal and what is CRM for a realty owner gets a congruence in its meaning as they move forward.
Sir.
Yeah, see, Maruti has got a call center which is hardware based, right? Now, there is a software utility which can be fed onto those hardware based. Typically, if you look at a hardware call center solution, you're talking of a capex initially, which is 50 lakhs plus. Ramoji City, my client in Hyderabad, similar application, Siemens quoted to them starting at almost about 2.5 crores. Something which we were able to deliver to them around 68 lakhs. Already delivered, functioning and happening, right? So, bigger brands, they go for hardware applications. There's a huge capex, there's a huge OPEX there. But they can afford it and they can do it. So, they're not my TG, they're not my target group. My TG is SME and middle market, which wants a call center but which can't afford a hardware call center. Thank you very much, Judy. Thank you very much.